Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. Do you know what time it is? It is time to start the show. Yesterday, I got my delivery from Pfeiffer Hobby Supplies, and within that delivery, I had a bunch of these little Peco joiner sleepers ordered. They're little cross ties with little notches cut into them. You can't see it here. I'll show it to you in a little bit. But they go where you put your rail joiners in between sections of flex track. So that's what we'll do today. We'll figure out how to install these and whether it's worth the effort and time to install these versus the old way I used to do it. So I'll meet you down at the far end. Let's go do it.
We can improve the look of our track from this to this. So what I'll be working on for the next few days is I'm going to start filling in these little blank spots here between the flex track and the standard track and turnouts with little filler ties. What I normally used to do is involved a lot of little trimming of these little filler ties to get them to fit in place. These are leftovers from installing the track. End up doing a lot of this kind of stuff. And then you have to sand them down and file them and do a whole bunch of grinding to get them to fit underneath the joiners. I found this little product here by Peco Streamline. It's called Joiner Sleepers Wooden Type for End Gauge Ties. And what they are is they're ties, kind of like these, but they have a little groove already pre-cut in them. So the rail joiner should fit down in between them, make them easier to install. As you can see, the rail joint is just slightly wide, so I still have to do a little bit of adjustment to them, get them to fit. But this might actually be a lot easier to install than doing all the filing and sanding to install these guys here. So I'm going to give these a try, tell you how they work, and we'll see if it's a good idea to use these or not. So pretty much we'll start with just one, just clip it. And I'm going to sand this little, because it's just a little bit, the gap is just a little bit narrower than the actual rail joiner is. And I think it's because Peco versus Atlas. A more aggressive file here. Actually, let's try. Remember, I'm just trying this, so this is the first time I've used these, so we're finding out together if they work or not. Yeah, I think that worked. Just grip them. Better. I'm thinking we're gonna actually have to lift the track up a little bit to fit these in place, and I guess that's the advantage of using little nails like I do. You just kind of pop them up a little bit. Turn them up a little bit. Make sure it's fairly clean. Slide it underneath. A little push down, and it seems to look pretty good. Yes, I'm going to have to probably come back with a little bit of glue for this, but I think this actually went in here pretty easily. It's kind of, as you can see, it's kind of free moving. So I'll come back with a little bit of white glue mix and I'll put on there. Once the ballast in place, it'll hold it in place, but that went pretty quick. Up here, let's bring the camera up here a little bit. My next spot, and I'm not going to do these right now, are where the insulators are. I'll still end up using the basic ties, but I'm going to have to trim them, cut them in half, fit them, and glue in those spots to fit those. But I'm not going to do that today. We'll try putting some more of these rail joiners down in here where the cork road bed is and see how well this procedure goes. Let's move the camera right here. So it looks like I'm going to probably need two of them would probably work just perfect for that spot. And I'm going to need one for there. Trim them up. The hardest part is just this little gap should be, the little gap right here should be just a little bit wider than it is. So I'm still doing a little bit of filing, which I really didn't want to do. So yeah, I'm going to just have to spend a little bit of time cleaning up, making this gap a little bit larger. So I'm taking my guess is that the PECO rail joiners, PECO, are just a little bit narrower than the Atlas. The joiner sleeper is the SL308Fs from PECO, and they have the pre-cut slot in them. So I still have to do a little bit of filing to them versus what I do on these. A little bit less work. So I have to go and install some like this, and I'll figure out which I really prefer. Granted, these are like a couple bucks, and you get, how many do you get in one of these packages? It looks to be about 25 or 30 of these for a couple bucks. So you're looking at a time savings. Here's something that might be a little bit easier. Might not need as much work. Just pop the nails up a little bit on the outside. Lay the sleeper or cross tie in here on its side like that. Then we just rotate it over. So let's see if we can flip it. That wasn't that bad. More or less, it's a need the right tool than anything else. But I didn't have to lift up as much of the nails to get that underneath. So that could be an option too. I'm going to install the rest of these PECO joiner sleepers, SL308F by PECO. So we're going to do it in fast cam. Just to anchor these little sleepers into place, I'm just using a little bit of white glue, like 35-50% white glue, water, and a dab of soapy water. It's not going to take much just to hold them there until we come in and ballast at a later point. I don't want them to kick around, so I'm just doing them like that. And hopefully these should just hold together in one spot just fine. So That's what I'm going to do. If it doesn't work, we'll find out when ballasting comes along. And here's what they look like when they're done. Looks much better as we go down here. We have no breaks in the tie pattern all the way down to the end. And you'll come up to here where I've stopped, and you can see that abrupt stop right there, but you can see the improvement of the tracks. If you look, there's one right there. And right there, the solder actually gives it away, not the fact that the cross ties. So it's always a good idea to put those cross ties in. It was fairly easy to do, and I'll continue doing it the rest of the way. What do you guys do? Do you guys make your own filler pieces, or how do you guys make your little cross ties to fill in the gaps that are left between your sections of flex track? Tell me down below. If you like this episode, give it a thumbs up and comment on it down below. If you like my channel, find that subscribe button located right down there and click on that. And if you want to be notified every time I post a video, find that little bell, ring on that bell, and you'll get notified every time I post a video. And as always, look for that Amazon mystery link down below. Click on that and see what is on my mind for today. And you know what? It's the end. So I will see your face tomorrow if you don't see my face first. So you guys have a great day.